quirk that I have as just as an individual is that I don't particularly like reading. I read a lot because I have to, because it's the only way you're going to learn about some things. But sitting still and reading a book for the amount of hours that it takes to read a whole book, book after book after book, subject after subject after subject, is not something that I'm given to. And just a little too restless. I read about as fast as anybody else I know in terms of words per minute, but as far as pages per day, I'm not going to get that many in. I'm just not. If I read 10 pages in a single day, that's a pretty good day of reading for me. So it'll quite easily take me 3 weeks or more to read a 200-300 page book. And so that's an inefficient way of gathering information, at least for my appetite. So I've become very critical of a lot of what's written about the occult and magic. And I don't mean that from a pompous, I know better than you do standpoint. It's more of from an ignorant, I don't know any better, and I'm convinced this other writer doesn't know any more than I do. That sort of a standpoint. I can smell my own ignorance in someone else's writing. So I look for certain things in books that I should probably make another video about, because that's going to be a digression. But basically, I just wanted to say that the worst books that I've ever read in my life, bar none, on any subject, are written about magic and the occult. And even though there are some exceptionally good books on that on these topics, most of, in terms of just number and proportion, most of the best books that have really carried me forward in my study of the occult are not about the occult at all. Having focused so narrowly on a specific thing that I'm trying to learn, the occult in general, I'm not really all that concerned about. Astrology, summoning spirits, all that kind of stuff doesn't have much appeal to me. What I am interested in doing is problem solving. The whole making things happen trip. That's what I want. I want more control over my life and prosperity and the things that I think pretty much anybody wants from magic or from a career. And having defined that pretty early on, I was able to pick up a book and drop it rather quickly if it didn't give me what I wanted. I'll give a book about 10 or 20 pages to start to deliver, and if it doesn't, I don't give it another 10 or 20 pages of my attention. I just go from book to book until I find what I'm looking for. In the process of discarding so many books so rapidly, I learned the hard way, and I learned late, that keeping a notebook is of vital importance. And I deeply regret the first several years that I was involved with this that I did not keep good records or a good diary. And it's kind of fortunate the way it worked out, because I wasn't learning much, so there wasn't as much to write down. But I quickly realized that I was going to go through 10 different 300-page books, and out of each one, maybe get a single line of insightful material that was the author's own personal perspective on the matter. And the rest of it was just going to be the same old shit regurgitated from the fucking Middle Ages about, you know, the Key of Solomon and the Tree of Life and all that kind of stuff, astrological correspondences and the tarot and just the same old shit again and again and again. And it doesn't take long to look at the table of contents and the index in a book and say, oh, I've got all this already, and just go on. So I burned through books really rapidly, and I've developed what you see here in the background is about a third of the occult books that I've owned over the years. These are the good ones that I've kept. I've kept one or two examples of the bad ones just as examples. On the other side of this wall in the next room is a bookcase that goes from floor to ceiling and goes from the wall to about here, and is filled with books that have nothing whatsoever to do with the occult. However, the occult significance of them is, to me, pretty readily apparent to a discerning eye. It takes a few years of looking at this stuff and trying to see what the common thread throughout, not just occult literature, but throughout, you know, really all of creation. That's what this is about. You start looking for that, and you start finding it. So I gather books that have you know, on the surface, nothing to do with magic, and that's really actually what I'm getting out of it. The mistakes that I made in the course of studying things the way that I have, like I said initially, I didn't keep notes as well in the beginning as I should have. I corrected that right away, and the benefit of that is immediately noticeable. So there's not really a lot to say about it other than just start keeping records and don't stop, and you'll benefit and profit from that tremendously. Another mistake that I think I made was probably being hesitant. Things really took off when I decided that it was best for me to put first things first, drop out of college, leave my job, leave my home, move from where I was living to here, and take up a new life with new friends and be a lot more open about this with the people that I meet. Not a particularly gregarious person, you know, people, I have friends, but I'm not a high profile individual. So I'm able to slowly and discreetly make friendships that reinforce this. It was for the first time in my life, it was a very positive thing. The things that I think I did right and that I would do the same way were I to do it again were that, number one, I went the solitary route, and I'm glad that I have not one single horror story to tell about the group that I joined that took all my money and strung me along, and they wanted me to keep bringing my girlfriend and whatever, you know, just all that kind of stuff that I keep hearing people say. I've never had a bad interpersonal relationship experience with the occult because I've kept it away from other people. So many other activities that I've been involved with, you know, when I was a kid or whatever, I kind of got burned out on because of the other people that were involved in them. And I've kept this away from that and allowed it to not be spoiled by the people that could spoil it. I did keep good notes once I got started, and I'll make a whole video on notes and how to get totally psycho with record keeping. And the third thing that I did was developing an eclectic sort of eye. I was mentioning earlier about how I look at books that are not about the occult and finding occult significance within them. That's not something that occurred to me particularly until probably, I mean, as a discrete thought, that's probably in the last 3 or 4 years that I've been thinking along those lines. But when I was looking at my own bookcase and going, gee, the occult's the most important thing in my life, and most of my books are not about the occult. And that kind of, you know, illuminated for myself the fact that what we're studying is reality in its entirety. And we're studying the reality of ourselves and the reality of the world we live in and the interrelationship between them. So there's really nothing that doesn't touch on this if you're focused on it. So that's pretty much the how and why of my way of getting started. And I'll get into the more details of what I actually did, the books I read, the notes that I took, and so forth in another video. But I wanted to pretty much explain what the reasons were for me doing things the way that I've done them, because it's an odd approach. Most people get involved with groups, and most people that I know are pretty much gravitate to the basic sources within occult literature. And so I just have a perspective of my own, which I feel like I ought to just explain a little bit, because that helps you understand why I'm not talking about all the things that I was just mentioning a second ago. Thank you.